Welcome to Dear Watchers, an Omniversal comic book podcast where we do a deep dive into the multiverse.
We are traveling with you through the stories and the worlds that make up the Omniverse of fictional realities we all love. And your watchers on this journey continue to be me, Guido.
And me, Rob, and an extra very special guest you will meet in a few moments. And if you are listening to us for the first time, well, welcome. We are here to be your guides, yay, through fictional realities. And we love talking to those people who create those other worlds and sharing that with all of you.
And so today is someone that we have mentioned in the credits countless times on our episodes. So over the course of our 90 episodes, we have said Janice Chiang's name, I don't even know, dozens of times, because Janice is a letterer with over 2,000 credits and over 40 years in the comic book industry. She's a legend. We do a full intro with her when we get into the conversation with her, but we wanted to start with thinking about what our biggest takeaways from this conversation now that we've had a chance to reflect after we recorded with her. So, Rob, why don't you start? What's something that you're going to keep thinking about in our conversation with legend Janice Chiang?
Well, it's funny because a letter, you just think of someone sitting there at the computer or in the old way with paper doing the lettering, and maybe it's not the most physical thing, but I love that Janice actually talked about the need for exercise because it can be so strenuous when you're sitting there doing this over and over, and she's often working on so many books. And I also think it speaks to her longevity, where she's keeping her instrument, her body, in this condition to do this very meticulous work so much. So that had not been something I had really thought of.
It's not even just her body. Something that stood out to me, and this isn't the point that I was going to identify in this opening, but I will mention her whole outlook is so positive. She has such a positive approach to work and life, and has a lot of wisdom and insight and thoughtfulness. And I think that exercise probably, I know, relates to that. You know, a healthy body, healthy mind, and you need to get moving. And she talks a bit about gardening as an activity. So it's not just her body, it's her mind. And she has such a healthy outlook. It was kind of an inspiration to hear how positive her approach was to her work and to her life. And I want to embody some of that, I know.
Yeah, I was made me think all those times when she was talking about gardening and also the activism work that she was doing. Those times away from your work, I would imagine, also helps that creativity. We know that sometimes when you're just doing the task over and over again, that's not really the most productive thing. So I think taking that step away, that breath, probably actually increases her creative mind.
Yeah. And in terms of her work and the creation she does in her work, I think, you know, you and I made a conscious decision when we started the show from the very first episode to mention every credit on the comic. And, of course, for many years, not everyone was credited. There were years when no one was credited. And then as credits started getting added, they were pretty restricted to the penciler or main artist and the writer. And then slowly over the years, finally, we're at a place where everyone who's working on the creative side of the comic is getting credited. Now, of course, production side is not getting credited. And we actually talked about that with Janice. But in terms of her work, I think something that I keep thinking about is how the pacing of a comic is controlled and the experience we have as readers in the pacing, and that the letterer actually has a lot to do with that. So obviously the panel breakdowns, the story breakdown, both of those things are creating a sense of pacing. But Janice had a few points she made about the way she constructs word balloons or what she chooses to fit in or how she chooses to fit it in, and thinking about the font and what goes in there, and that it had to do with pacing. And it just made me realize that something I think anyone who loves comics one of the features of sequential art we love is the controlled pacing. Unlike, let's say, a novel or a movie. A novel, you have total control over the pacing, right? No one is directing your pacing of that. And then a movie, you have no control over the pacing other than pausing it. Comics are that nice hybrid where the artists and the creators are constructing a pace for us. And we, but we have some agency and control over how fast we turn the page, how fast we go from panel to panel. And so it was really interesting to start thinking about the letterer's role in that, because I think often we don't realize the way the letterer is contributing to our experience of the book.
Yeah, and I for one had no idea that the letter was often placing those word balloons and also helping construct the layouts as well and all that stuff. I think letterer, it's a title that we see all the time in comics, but I for one didn't know everything that went into it and also everything that has changed over time as it's moved to digital. And that's the fascinating thing about Janice's career, is she's seen that entire arc in terms of the actual work that goes into it and how that role has changed and how the comics industry has really changed as well.
Yeah, well, let's get into that conversation.
And with that, welcome to episode 91, and let's check out what's happening in the multiverse with today's conversation.
And that is a wrap on our conversation with Janice Chiang. It was great.
Yes, we could have easily talked to her for several more hours. So many more things that I'm eager to learn about the industry and about her life and journey.
And hopefully we will.
Mm-hmm. And you can follow Janice on all the other platforms. Those links are in the show notes. And also check out her amazing work with Storm King Comics.
And you can follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, social media at Dear Watchers, dearwatchers.com. You can find more episodes on there. You can click to join, support us.
And in the words of Uatu, keep pondering the possibilities.